Imagine you are painting a picture. It is a lovely picture that you take immense pleasure in creating. You are deeply engaged in crafting the minute details, the fine lines, the broad strokes, the embedded shapes that define your art and give it life. Now suddenly, someone comes in from behind and smudges your painting with a big blob of red. Oh, what a spoiler. Then another person comes and throws his colors to your painting. You allow everyone to mess up your painting because you are too nice to say no. But in the end, your painting does not even remotely look like the one you wanted to create at the beginning. So you sit down and start crying because now your painting is spoiled and you don't know how to fix it. This is actually the picture of your life that you came here on earth to paint. You allow everyone to dictate how your life choices should be, what you should do, how you should play, how you should behave, what you should create. Then you are miserable and you don't know why. You follow what others tell you to do to win their approval. But there is no trace of joy or excitement left in your life as you become horribly misaligned from your true self. Then you fall prey to all sorts of chronic, acute, or terminal illnesses. Why? Precisely because you have allowed others to paint the picture of your life that you came here to paint. You have listened to your father who wanted you to be a doctor when you secretly wanted to be a rock star. Thus, you have become a slave to the programming, not a master of your destiny. So what creates this programming? It is our belief systems, cultural conditioning, familial upbringing, religious doctrines, societal dictates and dogmas that go on to paint our individual realities. In fact, the program takes hold of our lives, twists it, twerks it, and we become a slave to it. What is perception and what is reality? Is there a difference between the two? If by the very act of observing something, the observer can affect the observed reality, then can you imagine what your perception does to your creation of reality? What belief systems and cultural conditioning do to your canvas of reality? Quantum theory states that reality does not exist until it is measured or observed. That means if you do not exist, there is no reality for you to navigate. There is nothing for you to experience. Life happens to you, through the filters of your own perception. And so your perception is everything. Now imagine what all our belief systems, societal programming, and conditioning do to our creation of reality. What if those programs and belief systems are dysfunctional? Bah, da, boom. It wreaks havoc as it has in many walks of life today. The science of epigenetics affirms that cultural and environmental factors are far stronger than our genetics. That means if you have an empowered consciousness, you will have an empowered immune system. Just because you are genetically predisposed to an illness doesn't mean that you will actually get the illness. It depends on how you live your life and what environment you live in that impacts your life choices. And so, when your perception of reality limits the expression of who you really are, disempower you, or discourage your dreams is when you fall sick. Some years ago, when I was in university, I had injured my back badly. I had two prolapsed intervertebral discs, and each day I spent a lot of money on physiotherapy at the university hospital in Singapore, where I was studying alone in a foreign country. Doctors had barred me from doing anything that I loved, like dancing, wearing heels, running, athletics, sports, climbing stairs. And I had become increasingly dependent on painkillers. Stronger painkillers could not alleviate my pain. Until one night, I had had enough. I could not live like that anymore. I suffered for nearly 3 years, and I decided to call it quits. I remember that night, I stepped outside of my hostel room where the racing tracks were. I used to be an athlete in school, and I missed running. So I stepped onto the tracks, and I started sprinting. I ran for nearly 2 hours, alone in the middle of the night with the stars. When I stopped, I thought my back would have been permanently damaged. But instead, my back wasn't hurting at all. It felt really good. At the time, I did not understand what had happened, but my back had completely healed, and I called it a personal miracle. But today, epigenetics is proving that our consciousness plays a huge role in determining whether we live a life free of diseases or illnesses or not. Our immune system, our healing mechanism, is not a protector. It is a confirmer of our consciousness. A disempowered consciousness creates a disempowered immune system, and vice versa. The environment, or the perception of the environment, controls our genetics. And that is good news. It means that we don't have to be limited by our genes or our physical conditions anymore, and that terminal or chronic illnesses are reversible. Just a shift in your perception can shift your reality as you become the masters of your destiny and not at the behest of your genes. Epigenetics is above gene genetics. You see, back then, I was in a career that I did not enjoy at all. IT was the popular choice, so I took it. But I had no clue what I really wanted to do in life, what my dreams were, what my passions could be. I was not happy and lived in a perpetual state of disempowerment. So I became a vibrational match to that back injury. Everything is vibration. The animal and plant kingdom communicate through vibrations. But we humans are most times out of sync with our own vibration. And everything is energy, and energy produces interference. So everything is connected. Thoughts are energy, and energy creates physical matter. Our bodies are not separate from our thoughts. Our minds play a huge role in our ailing or our healing. Think about it. The MRI reports, the doctor's diagnosis, the medical bills, the hospital visits, the painkiller prescriptions all had enslaved me to a life of pain and suffering until I decided not to let the diagnosis cripple me. That's when everything changed for me. That night, I made a promise to myself never again to do anything in my life that I did not enjoy. And after graduating, I started traveling the world. I did extreme sports. I climbed mountains and hiked for days. I backpacked with heavy loads. I climbed down waterfalls and started dancing again. But my back never complained since then. Not only that, I never needed to go to a doctor during all those years I was on the road, traveling and living across different continents. I internalized this mind-body connection at a profound level of my consciousness. I knew that I had broken the barriers in my perception, hence my outside reality had shifted. You see, we create all these walls in our consciousness, these limitations, restrictions, inhibitions of what is possible and what is not, what we should do and what we shouldn't, that dictate everything that we do, think, say, act, or create in our lives. Break these boundaries in your perception and recreate your reality. Always in life, there are two paths. One is the path of our hearts, and the other is the path of others' expectations of us. Both paths are equally difficult, lined with challenges, struggles, and life lessons. But treading the path of our hearts will make us feel immense joy and make this journey worthwhile and meaningful. While treading the path of others' expectations of us will make us bitter, resentful, and sick over time. But how to recognize this path of our hearts? It would be easy for me to say, follow your joy. But following our joy is not an easy thing to do. It may not even be apparent to us what makes us feel real joy. For example, what makes us happy may be dependent on external factors like our parents' approval, our friends' appreciation. But what if what you really want to do, they don't approve? Then you won't know how to tune in to your own joy. When we are born into this world, the first 8 to 10 years of our lives, we experience this world solely through our feelings, before we learn reasoning or thinking. Feelings are the language of our soul. But it is also during these vulnerable years of our lives that most of the programming of society is downloaded into our subconscious minds that go on to determine how the rest of our lives will be lived. Our worldview and belief systems formed in childhood run the show of our adult lives, and most times we aren't even aware of it. If you are struggling at an area of your life, it is because you have a program that does not support your achieving it. You probably picked up that dysfunction from your parents or grandparents or ancestors, and it comes out in your life as unconscious behavior, blind spots. And unless you make a conscious change in the fabric of your reality to eliminate these limiting programming, even diseases and illnesses can be predictable. It is these programmings that limit the expression of who you really are. Instead of steering your minds in the direction that you want it to go, you become a slave to all this conditioning. Less than 5% of our reality is controlled by our own minds. The rest is coming from others. You see, we become codependent on external source for guidance and information on our life paths, as we do not trust our own intuitive knowing. Your perception holds the key to everything in your life. If there is something that you wish to experience that is outside of your current belief system, it cannot manifest for you. Mom says study engineering. Dad says be a doctor. Boss says be the best salesman. Guru says sacrifice is happiness. And you allow them all to paint your reality. How can anyone know what you came here on earth to create? If you ask others, they will probably give you their visions to paint on your canvas of reality. If you listen to the noises of the world, you will be lost. Your thoughts will be muddled. You won't have clear signs. And you won't know what is true for you. If you wish to know what is true for you, tune in to how you feel. We are taught to supersede our feelings with reasoning and logical thinking. But you should have the courage to listen to your own intuitive guidance. And that is how you will hone your true destiny. And that will bring you joy. People try so hard to be like one another, to walk the same path as others, to mold themselves to others' expectations. When you were born to stand out, when no two snowflakes are alike, no two people will walk the same path here on earth. There is one time when the program ceases to run our life. It is when we fall in love. We live in a continual state of bliss, imagining, dreaming, wishing, desiring. And that is our true identity, to live in a state of limitless possibility.
It is a state of being when you are conscious of the present moment instead of letting your subconscious programs run the show of your life.
Falling in love does not necessarily mean getting into a relationship. It is just a state of being that opens us up to the myriad realities and infinite possibilities of life. And so, this is when our conscious minds are in the present moment, and that is where our creativity resides. It beckons us to live a higher reality, a grander truth, a larger vision. It throws us outside of the programs.
It holds our wishes and desires and what we want from life.
And so, as your eyes open, you can now clearly see that you have been painting this picture of your life all along with the brushes of your fears, worries, anxieties, traumas, disappointments, disempowerment, dysfunction, and doubts. But that you can change your brushes. You can create a new reality with the brushes of your dreams, desires, visions, expectations, hopes, empowerment, boundless perception, and recreate your reality. Paint a new picture with anything that you like. Erase the parts of your picture you don't like.
Whitewash or blacken out the painting altogether and start over.
The only limitation is your perception that you have limitations. Therefore, you start painting a new reality with your newfound colors of perception. How does your life look then? Where do your dreams begin and where do they end? Suddenly, for no reason at all, life begins to smile. The painting is an extension of the painter's soul. You cannot tell the painter from the painted, for they are one. So go ahead and create your masterpiece. The world is waiting to see your painting. Namaste.